the field light, all day light, all night light, on the blue light, on fist light, defense light, his squad light, house call light, in the sound light, in the sound light, in the sound
Take your failures, turn them into successes. Use obstacles as stepping stones. A donkey once fell into a well. The farmer heard the cries of the donkey and came to the well. The farmer could see no way to get the donkey out of the well. The donkey was very old and well, and the well needed to be closed up. Alright, so the farmer decided to simply bury the well and the donkey. The farmer started to shovel dirt into the well. The donkey saw what was happening, but it did not panic. Instead, every time the dirt hit the donkey's back, he would shake the dirt off and then step onto the dirt. Eventually, the dirt reached the top of the well and the donkey jumped out. Alright? Sometimes the things that you think will bury you are stepping stones to your success. If the donkey had done nothing, the dirt would have quickly engulfed him. But the donkey used the dirt that was meant to bury him as a way to save him. Failures can serve to bury you, or they can be stepping stones to your success. All too often, people give up when they're close to having a big breakthrough. During that time, when it seems like there is no hope, be faithful, stick with it, and continue to work hard. And I want you to think about this and talk about it. Let's all mention this and get each other better in this regard. What should you do with failure? It's different. Now we gotta start talking. What should you do with failure? This is a real question, Kali Bradford.
Learn from it.
Use them as stepping stones.
You can't just say what
he said. Like, see, I heard a couple different things. Let's go up front and we'll work our way back.
Use them as stepping stones.
Use them as stepping stones. What does that mean? That's easier said than done. A lot of people say that. Oh, I'm going to use my failure as a stepping stone. Tell me how that works. If we lose a game, how do we use it as a stepping stone?
Learn from it. And then learn from your mistakes and then make yourself better from your mistakes.
Learn from your mistakes and make yourself better from your mistakes. All right. You learn from the class. What have you done to learn from the class? What have you done?
I should study more.
Not what you should have done. What have you done? Because you're supposed to learn from every mistake, right?
Yeah.
Okay. You think about that. Give me something that's even easier for you to handle. Watch this. Mom Duke said, take out the trash. You ain't take out the trash. She come on, she starts screaming.
I give you a better one.
How about when she asks, you do it? Because 9 times out of 10, if you like any other regular man, you say, okay, I'm gonna get that, I'm gonna knock it out. And then something come up, and then you forget. And then everybody, hey, get online on the game. And then you forget. And then your girl call, and then you still, and then she go to work, she asks you to take the trash out, she come on the next day, you had every intention as a man to take the trash out, but you forgot. So learning from your mistake is, when you get 42, you learn from your mistake. When your wife asks you to do something, or when your children ask you to do something, you do it immediately. So now, what have you done to learn from your mistake in Mr. Kufa class? What have you done? Not what you're going to do, what have you done? And if the answer is nothing, say nothing. Then he not learning from his mistake. But that's the truth though, I'll take that. But you gotta learn from your mistake, right? So if you got the ball in your hand, you fumble the ball, we sit you on the sideline, you learn from your mistake, right?
Yeah.
Then you don't lose the ball no more, because you wanna play. You understand where I'm coming from? That's why things have to be immediate. This is what I never understood this, and it's never happened in my house this way. Wait till your daddy get home. Any of y'all ever heard that before?
Yeah.
Wait till your daddy get home. Okay? Now watch. Watch this. I was blessed, but not blessed, in the same breath that it was no mother to ever say that. So the first person that got home was my daddy. So when it wasn't done right, it was no conversation. That's why for me, when I say I'm going to do something, I just do it. Because if I didn't do it, my old man went upside my head. Period. It was no wait till your daddy get home. I never had that. When I got to college and I was like, they tripping, man. They ain't playing me. I'm leaving. I'm transferring. He said, I didn't make that decision to send you to Virginia Tech where it's cold and you not playing. That was your decision to go. So now you're there. You deal with it. But how I'm going to get home? I don't know. I ain't got no money for you to get home. So I had one or two options. Find the $400 to get on the plane to go home, or stay and tough it out. But what did I do? I learned from the mistake. The next year, I planned it better. I made sure I did things better. I prepared in the off-season better. All y'all gonna graduate, get ready to go to somebody's school, but everybody think
when they get to their senior year, you done. You're not done. You're not even begun your life yet. Think about it. 20 years ago, I graduated from high school. 20 years ago. Think about what I said. In 1995, I graduated from high school. Think about that, y'all. That's almost 25 years ago. Real talk. I didn't even live half my life. I haven't lived half my life yet, I don't think. Maybe when I get 50, I'm going to say I lived half my life. That's 8 years from now. Right? So you still got a lot to learn and a lot to do. You got a lot of decisions to make. All right, question number two. Y'all ready? Go. I didn't want to change that, man. I'm sorry to go off on you. Y'all ready? Where we at? Here we go. Did the donkey ever panic? Never panic. Right? That's simple. Write it down if you got your book. Don't have your book. Donkey never panicked. Right? You never ever panic. So what happens when you don't, when you do panic? Let's take it from a different perspective. When you're, hey, Gavin, you in the room. When things get frustrating for you, how does it turn out for you? Well, how does it turn out? Not what you do.
Even worse.
Oh, it goes bad.
It goes bad. So think about it. Think about this. Let's take a real life example, all right? If we're in the building and something goes bad in the building, like it's happened a couple times, like right in the last week, right? El Paso, got it, David. If it goes bad, what are you gonna do?
I'm gonna do our drill.
You better go through your drill, right? You better find a way to go in this building. You better go through your drill. All right? Say it again. Tomorrow.
I don't die.
Huh?
I don't die.
You don't die. Okay. Why you not gonna die? Because this morning I listened to a young girl talk about something. Go ahead. Tell me why you're not gonna die.
Because my brain's gonna just click to a different level. Like people depend on me. I feel like my being on this earth, like so many people depend on me. Like so I need them there. Like he ain't gonna be. I mean, You gotta do what happened in Times Square two nights ago.
Y'all know Times Square, New York.
Yeah.
Guy riding on his motorcycle, it backfired. All right? Pow, pow. All right, so what did everybody do?
Panic.
Okay, everybody panic. It's on the news, I can show you it's on the news, everybody went crazy. Okay, the girl said this, she was walking out of the theater. She had trained for this, she works for NBC, and she was an intern for NBC. She said she walked out of the theater. When she walked out of the theater, she saw everybody running, she said she froze. But she had practiced this before. She had been in this situation before, she thought she was good, but she froze, right? And then until her roommate said, you gotta run, she didn't run. Everybody understand that? So until you get in the situation, you don't know if you're gonna panic, right? So you gotta psychologically put yourself in the situation or go through the experience to know. Like you gotta train your brain or you gotta go through it to know. The great thing about us is we all been through it. Let's talk about what we do right now. Everybody in this room has been through it. I don't think there's anybody in this room that did not play youth football. Anybody? Everybody played on somebody's team somewhere, right? So you've been playing football your whole life. Alright, so listen, as you football, right? So everybody in here, you've been in this situation before. So now what happens? When the referee blows the whistle at the beginning of the game, what's gonna happen?
Kickoff.
So you either gonna kick off or you'll kick off return. Right? If you score a touchdown, what happens? You gotta go for what? So you've been through these things before, right? So it's an experience. How do we know what the donkey been through before?
We don't know.
So some things may just be innate. Some on my back, I just shake it off. Some things you have to learn. Some things you just know. Being in our environment, we know. Like everybody in the room know. Like you got to compete to be here and be your best to play. Y'all know even our third guys, our second guys, our fourth guys, when they compete here, they go other places and they are the star. Right? That's innate. That's innate in us. That's the culture that we've developed. That's why I say you gotta protect our culture. What we do. What it looks like to everybody else and what it is to us is very, very different. Does that make sense?
Sure.
That's been developed. So the donkey didn't panic, because he's been there before. Whatever the situation was, he's been there before. Or it's innate in him.
or something on my back, I just shake it off and I keep moving. When a teacher says something to you that you don't like, is it innate or have you been in this situation before? See, y'all get to somebody in college, a professor say something to you, that ain't nothing I dealt with Ms. K before. Just keep it moving. You understand what I'm saying? Or you say, I'm gonna be all right. Whatever, regardless of what this person say, I'm gonna be all right. Right? You've been in big situations where you're playing for money and you drop a pass. So now, if you drop a pass in a game, I'll bounce back. So, we down 14 in the state semifinals. Just take a deep breath. Relax. Relax. I've been in a situation, on the coach staff here where Felton, who playing for Kansas City right now, dropped a two-point conversion to tie the game up. We losing the whole game. We come back, we finally get close, we throw the two-point conversion, he drops it. This is a wide receiver that's playing in the NFL right now. He drops a two-point conversion. I turned and looked at Coach Simmons and said, that's right. I said, I'm gonna kick his onside kick with a kicker that never kicked the onside kick before. I said, guys, I need y'all to get the ball, let's go. They said, you straight, coach? I'm straight. I ain't no doubt, we work on this, we practice this. I have no doubt in my mind we're gonna get this onside kick. We got the onside kick, we won the game. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's all it was. And the guy that we threw the ball to, playing for the Jets tomorrow night, we're gonna watch him have a good time, watch him run around and make people look stupid in the NFL tomorrow night. You understand what I'm saying? He gonna go ham. You think he panicking? The smallest guy on the field, y'all think he panicking? He ain't thinking twice about it, because he been in this situation. I'm gonna send him a text. The text gonna say, remember when you were a sophomore and everybody counted us out and we had to throw the ball to you at the end of the game and you had to catch it with one hand with two people draped all over you so we can go to the next round of the playoffs. And he gonna say, yeah, coach, I remember. Yeah, you've been here before. So when somebody yelling at you full speed, running down, they trying to take your head off, just catch the ball, because that's all you do. He been there before, right? He been there before. This somebody y'all know been there before. So the donkey been in that situation, or it's in there. All right, next question.
Thank you.
forget tomorrow, forget yesterday, forget what happened last week, forget what happened in December. It's today. Right now, the most precious thing you got, right now. Y'all understand where I'm coming from?
Yes, sir.
So when you walk outside the door, you got every opportunity to walk back to the field house and stay here and stay, or walk to the field and give us everything you got. It's either one or the two.
We're at 808.